get this in before we break. You're an atheist.
Yes. I could do the same to you, you know.
Why?
Since you're the host, I won't say it, but in other circumstances, I would say I don't approve of religion. I recognize your right to it. But
yeah, you don't approve of religion because?
Because it's mystical, because it's based on faith, not on reason and facts.
So for you, but not for others, okay, what do you care? Somebody wants to worship a Christmas tree or a telephone pole, that's their business.
I wouldn't stop them legally. I said I grant them the right to believe anything they want, but I don't have to approve. And the question was, I would say, you know, at them.
Yeah.
But I would never pass any laws to stop them.
Yeah. You've got to allow that you're not smart enough to know whether or not there's a God.
Yes, I am, and everybody here is.
Is what?
Smart enough. That doesn't take much intelligence. Do you know why?
Why?
Because you're not called upon, I cannot be called upon, to know a negative, or to prove a negative. If there is a God, and you prove it, that's fine. But you can't tell me, you can't know that there isn't. I would say, yes, I know that there isn't, because I've been given no evidence.
Well, but the fact that you've been given no evidence may mean you just haven't been in the right place at the right time.
Well,
I mean, it may mean that.
No.
No.
It could mean that about somebody else, but not about me.
Right. Okay.
Because I'm interested in
this. Sure. I honestly don't want to be theatrical about this, and I'm not suggesting that you haven't been in this dialogue before, but I still have a lot of problems with... I think atheists are as arrogant as many of the so-called Christians or religionists that you decry. I'm saying...
Arrogant in what way?
In that you are here with your certainty saying there is no God, and anybody who believes there is it is almost a suggestion that you're foolish if you believe that there is. And I think
no,
that's a little arrogant and condescending if you...
No, I don't call it foolish. I would have, if you want to tell the truth, I think it's a bad sign psychologically. It is a sign of a psychological weakness of a man who is afraid to stand on his own mind and his own responsibility. Mm-hmm. Because you see, the absence of proof has gone on for centuries. Mm-hmm. Every argument for the existence of God is incomplete, improper, and has been refuted, mm-hmm. and people go on and on because they want to believe. Well, I regard it as evil to place your emotions, your desire, above the evidence of what your mind knows.
Okay, and I regard it as intellectually lazy to look at the universe and to suggest, as you seem to be doing, that this is all some accident.
I didn't say that.
Well, how in the world did we get all this order? Aren't you impressed with that?
No, because the order is only in good cases in the minds of your scientists who are able to understand some part of it.
Yeah.
But there isn't an artificial order in the universe, and it's not chance. What would be the alternative? Nature. That the universe, and remember, the universe is everything that exists, has always been here. Because you cannot discuss or know anything about what was here before anything existed. A zero.
Well, the question's
doesn't
absurd.
Exist.
The question is absurd.
That's
what
right.
was here before there was something here?
Exactly.
If there was something here before there was something here, then there
right.
was something there already.
Exactly.
And then we have to ask what was there first.
That's right.
All right. So all but I'm asking, Miss Rand, is excuse me.
One thing, but that's what you're doing with the idea of God, speaking philosophically.
True.
You say you need someone to explain the order, but what will you then have to explain God? You have to take what exists as a fact. And you start with what exists, and you see how much you can learn about it. But
aren't you really filled with wonder when you look up at the stars?
No, and I don't like to look at them. I love this earth. You know when I'm filled with wonder? When I look at skyscrapers, at the man-made, at what men were able to achieve on their own, unaided, so-called, mind, without the help of faith,
yeah.
desires or any sort of mysticism.
You know what you see in those